between the Mahagathbandhan as well as the NDA in Bihar. This was unexpected. India Today's exit polls did show the Mahagathbandhan gaining massively, but here it seems like it's a neck and neck fight. A close contest. I have with me our India Today's consulting editor, Rajdeep Sardesai, to give us a glimpse into what's happening at the thick of things. Rajdeep, here we see the numbers. Neck and neck fight between the NDA and the RJD Mahagathbandhan. They're 122 and 113. As the number that it stands now, what are the key takeaways through the day today?
I think the key takeaway is clearly that Bihar has thrown up a very fragmented verdict. You know, when 243 seats end up with 120, 120 or in that range, Nabila, it's clear that the voters of Bihar remain in a way undecided. I mean, let's be honest, this is not a clear verdict for anyone at this stage. It could change to 130, 110, but the margins are narrow. If you look at vote share, one side has got 38%, the other side's got 37%. The critical factor actually is the 25% others. Non-NDA, non-Mahagathbandhan parties have got almost 25 to 27% vote.
Right.
That's what is the critical factor in this election.
Well, it seems like the game changer here so far, from what I've heard you speaking on air, that the women voters are somehow the key to the NDA gaining big this time on counting day, which is a spin to what we displayed on the exit polls.
You know, it was one of my X factors that I had on the show last night. I've always seen Nitish Kumar in the last 15 years attract a large or a disproportionate number of women voters. He is seen as someone who has reached out to the women voters, given 50% reservation in panchayats, prohibition, cycles for girls. And when I saw yesterday, I think it was, that the PIB release saying that 5% more women have voted than men.
Right.
I thought that this was a warning signal. You can check with Access My India. I told them, look, you better look at this number, because I think that is a number. Again, it's purely anecdotal. I don't think we can prove it empirically at this moment that more women voted for the JDU. But my sense is that women in general have, over the last 15 years, tended to support Nitish Kumar and Narendra Modi. And that may have been a critical factor.
Well, the fact is that larger number of voters have come out to cast their vote. 4 crore people have cast their vote this time amid the pandemic. More number of booths that have also been placed. And that's what's really taking that much time for the counting to end. What does this speak and suggest to you amid this pandemic?
Look, at the end of the day, the Bihari voters are extremely politically savvy or very politically astute and is very interested in politics. And I think in times of economic distress, in times of reverse migration, in times of floods, he or she have come out and voted because they believe their vote counts. Look, this is a strange election. I think there is a mood for badlav or change, but there is no commitment among a large enough number of people to vote for the other side.
Mm.
So I think partly that also reveals the limitations of the Mahagathbandhan, and particularly because it really wasn't a Mahagathbandhan.
This would be the best to hear from you. What are the limitations of the Mahagathbandhan? We've heard enough.
It's not a Mahagathbandhan. It's not Maha.
Huh.
You see, Congress is the kamzor kadi. I have been saying this for days. You can go back, rewind to all
right.
my program.
In fact, they weighed down the RJD's prospects.
70 seats they've contested. They're leading in about 19-20. That's a 30
right.
less than 30% strike rate. RJD is doing well. They're winning 75-80 seats out of 144. So their strike rate is above 50%. The strike rate of the left is remarkable. Highest, 21 out of 29. The Congress has done to the Gathbandhan in a way what they did to the DMK in Tamil Nadu in 2016.
Right.
Brought it down.
Right.
You know, the Congress needed a minimum 35-40%, 40%.
So their showing is not even on par with their 2015. It's disappointing. I'm sure RJD may have learnt a bitter lesson. But here, if you look at it, AIMIM here of them all could,
you know,
I don't know, be the kingmaker, if at all.
Look, if it is 118-118, they will be kingmaker. They're going to win about 5 seats, which in itself is remarkable. They won a first seat last year in a bipole in Kishanganj. But in the Simanchal area, large Muslim majority areas, the voters in many places have chosen the AIMIM over the RJD and Congress. So there was no minority consolidation as such
right.
around the RJD to the extent that maybe they had hoped. Certainly not in Simanchal.
Hmm.
And there was a counter-polarization instead. And I think the counter-polarization plus a fragmentation in certain areas of the Muslim vote meant those 5 or 10 seats went away, and those 5, 10 seats will cost this election.
It's big time. In fact, one would expect the LJP to be the kingmaker, but it's somehow been reduced to a vote cut to a party, exactly what the BJP call them?
Well, you know, they've damaged the JDU, no doubt about it. But the damage that OAC has done is not just in terms of votes, but also in terms of seats. And when you've lost 10 seats in a closely run election, you know, that makes the huge difference. I don't know whether he'll be kingmaker. That'll depend on the final numbers. But he's certainly become a major player.
No doubt. And if you're really looking at it, the BJP's performance here has been stellar in Bihar this time. Their strike rate is the best. They're the largest. They've got the largest vote share, it appears. They're neck and neck with RJD. Do you think if the BJP had projected another chief ministerial face in Bihar, that would have been beneficial for the BJP possibly?
I thought so initially, but I don't think so now. When I see, look, Nitish Kumar also has a vote. He has a certain vote bank that he has cultivated, women, extremely backward castes, Mahadalits. He has his own vote. You know, you must see Bihar as a triangle. In the last 15 years, whenever two sides of the triangle meet, the third side is in trouble. So when JDU and BJP get together, the RJD is in trouble. In 2015, RJD and JDU got together, BJP in trouble. So I think we can't suggest at this moment that the BJP on its own would have won Bihar. I think what they would have been is a more effective force in Bihar. Let me put it that way. I think they would have been a much more effective force if in terms of widening their own base, but I don't think they would have won. They needed the JDU. You know, Nitish Kumar brings a certain vote to the sort of party in a way. I think in the future, the BJP will look at fighting on its own.
Maybe have someone from their own crop.
No, but certainly not have a situation where they will give half the same number of seats to the JDU as they got. Like Maharashtra.
Right.
Over time, they said, we are party number one, you're the team B.
Yeah.
I think after this election verdict, where they're almost, you know, well ahead of the JDU's tally, the BJP is going to say, our chief minister, we are the party in the driver's seat. You're the supporting cast. That's definitely going to happen in the next 5 years.
Right. But today's election indeed has been a thriller Tuesday, like we've been calling it. Rajdeep, here, the BJP has, one expected that the NDA has, you know, is facing anti-incumbency, or Nitish Kumar is facing anti-incumbency. But to be honest here, that hasn't been the case here. He seems to be a strong leader, yet it could likely be very possible that Nitish Kumar could be the next chief minister once again. So this whole anti-incumbency talk and the narrative that was over the last few weeks, that's been busted. Do you believe that Nitish has really worked hard?
I don't think anti-incumbency has been busted. There was anti-incumbency. Remember last year, the NDA got 39 out of the 40 Lok Sabha seats in Bihar. They've come down to a tough fight. There was anti-incumbency. The opposition was not good enough or was far too divided to capitalize on it. To fight a force like the BJP, you need to be completely united.
True.
I don't think that the opposition was.
All right. And then in that case, would you believe that BJP's nationalism campaign, their poll plan, speaking of Article 370, abrogation, CAA, they've spoken about India, China, Pulwama, time and again on their campaign platforms. Prime Minister Modi has spoken about it largely. Do you think that hasn't really trickled down too well, if you see, considering it's a close fight here, maybe more relevant issues could have been more effective?
No, Nabila, I think what happened was there was an element of polarization, especially in the last couple of rounds. Please be clear, this politics of polarization, if the Congress was looking to sort of attract the Muslim vote or the RJD, there was a counter polarization. Now, I won't call it nationalism, but some of the sort of speeches that were made about Bharat Mata Ki Jai, about the Jinnah controversy, all of which in some way play at the back of the mind. Don't rule that out. There is a counter polarization taking place in states like Bihar. So I think that did play a role, especially in the last two rounds, particularly in the last round in Kosi Simanchal.
Right, there are a couple of questions that are coming up, Rajdeep, if you could, you care to answer. Why EVM counting could not be completed within 6 hours?
I think they've explained that there were far more counting centers this time. And because of COVID protocols, they had to necessarily ensure certain protocols put in place, which has slowed down the counting. We are seeing that over successive elections, because also the VVPAT system and the paper trail and the checking that goes after every round, it has slowed down the process. Plus, more people have voted in Bihar than in past elections.
Okay, another Suman asks, Rajdeep, would you mind endorsing the fact that MIM has been pitched by the BJP to claim its pound of flesh in form of minority votes?
Well, I'm going to ask, I have Asad Owaisi coming on my show, I'll certainly ask him this question. Look, Mr. Owaisi is usually attractive to a certain class of younger, poorer Muslims today. His rhetoric strikes a chord with them. And when you ask him this question, he says, look, I'm in politics. I'm going to fight for every seat I want. I'm not here to do favors to anyone.
This is a close call. We're not calling out the election as yet, but what's your prediction, Rajdeep? Despite the exit poll prediction of India Today, you had your own personal, idea of this whole.
You know, my number in the office sweepstakes, I can reveal it here, was 132 for the NDA.
Okay.
Actually, I was already going to go to 123, and then I did because 6 is my lucky number.
And for the RJD.
So then I went 132. And for the RJD, at that time, was 100. Look, now look at this, 120 is playing 116. You know, this is as close as it gets. I wrote a piece 3 weeks ago. Sometimes, you know, you get it right, sometimes wrong. I call it the super over election. It's there in public domain, so it's not something I'm saying now. This is a super, out of these 7,
yeah.
5 are OAC.
Yeah.
Add 116 to 5, it becomes 121. This is the kind of election Bihar
now,
is going on.
Now, in that case,
in this 120 to 116, this could change because there are about 27 seats where the margin is less than 1,000 votes.
Rajdeep, but considering, if at all, looking at the numbers and looking at this close fight here over the end of tonight, first of all, will it get over by tonight?
I think by midnight it'll get over. I remember there was a Madhya Pradesh election like this, which went, 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Again in the month of November or December, went till about midnight. Look, I love politics, so I'm very happy to do this.
So this is exciting. You have the NCP, Sharad Pawar, saying that the trend here shows, hope. It gives hope to all of us. Basically, the Mahagathbandhan mood across the country has been on since Karnataka, and then you have,
But make it a Mahagathbandhan. Where is it? I mean, you're not exactly. Really, that's the thing. You know, if you don't unite, the BJP is the most formidable political machine in the country.
Sure.
You don't have a chance. So, Sharad Pawar can say what he wants. But yes, to be fair to him, what they did in Maharashtra came together. If this had happened in Bihar, who knows? Sharad Pawar then should pick up the phone and tell Nitish Kumar, you should be part of our Mahagathbandhan. Won't happen. I think, in my super over column, I had hinted at that. What if Nitish does what, Uddhav did in Maharashtra? I don't think he will. He's got very few options. He and Tejasvi don't have a relationship. So I 121, 115.
So who
it's
do you
just
think
changed.
now when this the numbers settle in, who do you think will go with who? You think the RJD, the Mahagathbandhan,
no,
the Horizons?
Anything above 118, I think advantage NDA. Anything above 120, advantage RJD.
Right.
So
and if at all it comes down to the Mahagathbandhan gaining, in that case, are we going to be looking at, one fears that the Diwali festival will be ruined with all the poaching that would begin. Do you fear that? Do you think that's going to come down to that?
Congress is a vulnerable party to poaching always. But I would like to believe, I hope that one side wins. We can have a happy Diwali. Whoever wants to be chief minister can be seen.
A quick word on Tejasvi Yadav here, considering he is the youngest chief minister you face, Rajdeep. If at all the Mahagathbandhan does come to power, do you trust his abilities here?
He's completely untested. And I think that's part of the problem. I think you need leaders with a clean slate. Tejasvi carried the baggage of his father. So for an older Bihari, they have memories of Lalu Raj. And I think that again was a weakness. He ran a fantastic campaign, in my view, Tejasvi. Did as well as he could have. But at the end of the day, I think he was faced with too many odds.
But why do you think he gained so much? Do you think it was because of sympathy for his father?
Anti-incumbency.
Okay.
Anti-incumbency.
Not
was
his
there.
Credibility.
No. There was genuine disillusionment over the years. Plus, you're in pandemic times. But look, given all that has happened, I would have expected the Mahagathbandhan to do slightly better perhaps in the end, even though my numbers were, as I said, 132 to the NDA. And that's simply because I think the NDA was more organized and has a better ground machine. Elections are won on the ground. They had the ability to reach out to the last mile voter in a way. The Mahagathbandhan was too reliant on Tejasvi. It was almost as if no one else was pulling their weight. The left did, the Congress didn't. This election, the Congress has lost this for them if these numbers hold.
All right, so we're waiting to watch you tonight. This is going to be a big show. Thank you very much, Rajdeep, for joining us.
My great pleasure.
Thank you very much. Do continue watching India Today, our detailed coverage on the Bihar election. Thank you.